This is our DIY catchment system. So this lets us have water in our sink, and we also have drinking water, which I'll talk about in a little bit. So if you look up there, we have some roof area, and we have a gutter. And the whole basic design of our system is that it's very simple and it's very cheap. So the gutters come in through this pipe, which is actually a piece of bamboo, into this bucket over here. And likewise on this side, this gutter comes in via this pipe into these buckets. These buckets are connected together via siphon pumps. And all that a siphon pump is it's a tube filled with water, with ideally no air. It's okay if you have a few bubbles like that, but the fewer bubbles you have, the better it works. And what a siphon pump lets you do is when water comes in this side, then the level will equalize across all of the buckets that are connected. And so for the spigot here, the faucet, we also have a siphon pump. So this tube is filled with water, and when you first set it up, you have to prime the siphon pump. So you can do that by sticking a tube like this in the water and submerging it completely, and then putting your thumb over one side and sort of lifting up, and that maintains water in the whole tube. And then so long as the water level from where the siphon pump starts is higher than where it terminates, so like if this were filled with water from this jug right here, and I let go with my thumb, then water would pour out, and it would continue to pour out until those levels were equalized. Or in this case, because our faucet is so much lower than the buckets, then the buckets will completely drain to wherever the bottom of the tubes are. So that's how we get our water. Unfortunately, there are some slugs around here that carry nematodes, so we don't want to get that kind of stuff in our drinking water. This is fine if you're going to boil the water, so to make, you know, to make soup or to make tea or coffee, that's all fine. But for drinking water, we have yet another siphon pump. This one is a Sawyer filter. So this is a 0.1 micron filter. They're about $20 or so. They're not too expensive. And this tube here is filled with water. And when we want to let the flow go, we just unstopper it. It's this little stopper I made, and water flows out. And that water is good to drink. So down here, we have just a water cooler, and you can push that spigot and get water. And to fill it up, we just let it empty out into there. This is another one of our independent water systems. We tend to go with small systems all over the place, kind of providing the resource where we need it. In this case, we have our shower set up. So this is our outhouse. It has a roof. Our shower does not. Maybe it will eventually. But this small roof, with the amount that it rains here, is enough to keep these two buckets, if you come over here, to keep those two buckets topped up. And those are connected via siphon pump, so they'll equalize their levels. Then coming out of it, we have this other tube right here that is yet another siphon pump, and it terminates in this faucet, which you can turn on, have a nice shower. It's not heated or anything, but it gets pretty hot around here, so that's very nice most of the time. And water comes out. But the one thing you want to be careful with siphon pumps is that you don't drain the water source down so much that you're going to start to get air in your line, because then you'll have to reprime the hoses, and that can be frustrating and annoying. To reprime the hoses, ideally you submerge the entire tube, but if you can't do that, you can also like take the end of the tube and pour water like with a jar into it until it fills up, and then just cap it with your thumb, stick it back in the water, and hopefully it'll be good for that. So that is our shower setup.